Sister, do you believe there is one God?
Yes, please.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ is God? Do you believe Jesus Christ is God?
Yes, I do.
You believe?
Yes, please.
Sister, if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me. If any Christian, including you, can point out a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says I am God, or where he says worship me, I, Dr. Zakir Naik, am ready to accept Christianity now. I am not speaking on behalf of my other Muslim brothers and sisters. I am ready to put my head on the guillotine. In fact, if you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28. I cast out devil with the Spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20. I with the finger of God cast out devils. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God is a Muslim. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was a Muslim. He never claimed divinity. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God, not God. A man approved of God amongst you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you by miracles and wonders and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. So when nowhere does the Bible says Jesus, peace be upon him, is God, so why do you believe he's God? Because the church says so. Do you believe in the Bible or do you believe in the church?
I believe in the Bible.
Where does the Bible say is God? So someone has told you a lie. So now when you have come to know the truth, nowhere did Jesus say that he is God, peace be upon him. I have given you so many quotations. So yet do you believe he is God? See, the brother who came earlier, he got convinced. He's seen my cassettes. He's seen my lectures. I'm asking you, yet do you believe Jesus is God?
According to the Bible, Jesus Christ came to die for our sins and was crucified.
Sister, you said Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, came to die for a sin and he was crucified.
Yes.
I told you earlier, sister, just before you, I proved that according to the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die on the cross. I told in the earlier answer. Did you listen to my answer, sister? Did you listen to my earlier answer?
Please, I didn't hear you all.
I quoted to you Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 40. That Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. And we know Jonah was alive, correct? Jonah was alive in the belly of the fish. So even Jesus Christ was alive, that means he did not die on the cross.
Please, I'll be happy if you can please explain to me how Jesus Christ died.
You are asking me to explain how Jesus Christ died. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die. So how can I explain to you died? As I told you, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says that as Jonah, you know Prophet Jonah? As Prophet Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. When Jonah was thrown overboard, was he dead or alive? Sister,
alive.
Was alive. In the belly of the fish, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. When the fish vomits out Jonah, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive, alive, alive. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Now when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was taken on from the cross and put in the sepulchre, in the tomb, was he dead or alive?
Please, the question again.
Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. You told me Jonah was alive, correct? In the belly of the fish. Jesus Christ, after he was brought down from the cross, He was put in the sepulcher, in the heart of the earth. When he was put in the sepulcher in the heart of the earth, was he dead or alive?
Alive.
Alive. That means he did not die. So if he did not die, how can you say that Jesus Christ died for our sins? It's mentioned in the book of Ezekiel, chapter number 18, verse number 20. The soul that sins shall die. The father shall not bear the iniquity of the son. Neither the son shall bear the iniquity of the father. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him. The wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him. But if the wicked turns and come back, he shall not die. So sin cannot be inherited according to the Bible. One human being cannot die for the sins of the other human being. Correct? So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not die. So now do you believe that he is a prophet of God? There is no place in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon, unequivocally says that he is God. Now do you believe that he is not God? Sister?
I'm convinced.
You're confused.
I'm convinced.
You're convinced, mashallah. So you're convinced Jesus is not God?
Yes, please.
Do you believe he's messenger of God?
I believe in messenger of God.
Mashallah. Do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?
Yes, please.
That means you're a Muslim. Would you like to say it in Arabic? If anyone who believes that there is no one worthy of worship except one true God, Allah, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, that means you're a Muslim. Would you like to say it in Arabic?
Yes, please.
Is anyone forcing you to become a Muslim? Is someone forcing you?
No.
Are you doing out of your own free will?
Yes.
Is anyone giving you money?
No one is giving me money.
Okay. I say it in Arabic and you repeat it. Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
Mashadu.
Anna.
Allah.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Abduhu.
Abduhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
I bear witness.
I bear witness
that there is none
worthy of worship
except Allah and I bear witness
that
Prophet Muhammad
is the messenger
and servant of God. MashaAllah, you have become a Muslim, and I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you Jannah. I pray to Allah to give you Jannah, to put you in paradise. And I pray to Allah to give you the best in this world and Amen. The hereafter. And once you have become a Muslim, all your previous sins have been washed away.
Amen.
And I pray to Almighty God that you read more of Islamic books, come closer to Islam, and you guide other peoples to Islam. Thank you very much, sister.
Yes, please.